If you're watching this video, you most likely recently learned that professional programs will specifically evaluate your math and science GPA as part of their admissions decision, and that GPA is different than the cumulative and upper division GPAs calculated by UCR and your RWEB student record. Before I walk you through using this AMCAS Excel doc to calculate your science GPA for professional schools, let's cover a few basics. First, professional programs will include all grades earned from any college or university when calculating a cumulative GPA. In addition, all grades earned from any college or any university in the departments of biology, life sciences, neuroscience, genetics, microbiology, and so on, chemistry, physics, math, and statistics are calculated into one science GPA, or sometimes referred to as BCPM GPA. Courses taken at a community college during high school also need to be included. Your BCPM or science GPA includes all lower and upper division science courses, whether they were required or not. This GPA includes all grades earned in science courses, including non-passing grades and C minuses, even if those courses were repeated. Professional programs do not practice grade replacement or forgiveness in the way that UCR or community colleges may have. So it is important to remember that all grades earned from any college or any university will be factored into your GPA for professional school applications. In addition, the science GPA is not the same as your upper division or major GPA. This science GPA is not calculated by UCR and cannot be found in your student profile account. Students who are unsure or concerned about their science GPA need to calculate and monitor their own BCPM GPA. In HPAC, we recommend using this AMCAS Excel doc to track your cumulative and science GPA for professional schools. As a final note, for transfer students, we know that when you transferred into UCR from your community college, your GPA did not follow you. However, since professional schools do factor in all grades earned from any college or university into your GPA calculation, your community college grades will still matter and need to be entered into your application GPA. This can be done effectively using this Excel document. Now, let's enter a few courses to calculate your GPA. First, it's important to know that it is ideal to use a PC with Microsoft Office, as you will need to use Excel. If you're using a Mac computer, you will need to download the Microsoft Office for Macs. This is available for download through UCR's Computing and Communications website. This Excel document will allow you to enter in all of your courses taken during college. Courses can be separated into your freshman year, into your sophomore year, junior year, senior year, as well as any post-bac courses, which are courses taken after completion of a baccalaureate degree. Under each academic year, you will be able to enter in the classes that you've taken into this first column. You'll enter in the grades that you received for each class. You'll enter in the units that were awarded by each home institution where you took the course. In this column, you'll be able to allocate which courses fall under the biology, chemistry, physics, or math designation by clicking this box. And in the final column, you'll be able to allocate which courses were taken on the quarter system by checking these boxes, and which courses were taken on the semester system by leaving them blank. When entering courses, please do make sure to enter the course number. For example, Psychology 1. In addition, in the following column, you can enter the grade. For example, we can say a B+, as well as the units taken. In this example, I would like to first start with the course taken on the semester system, and so therefore the units generally will be 3. However, you should request an unofficial copy of each transcript from every institution that you've ever attended and follow the courses on those transcripts when entering your coursework into this GPA calculator. So if you took a 3-unit class on the semester system, we'll want to make sure that we enter this as 3 units. And then in this final column, we'll leave this box unchecked to make sure that the allocation designation matches the units of being on the semester system. going back to the column with biology, chemistry, physics, or math, since this is a psychology course, it would not fall under the BCPM category and therefore will also be left unchecked. As we entered in this course, it's now calculating an overall GPA for the freshman year of a 3.3. As we continue to enter courses, that GPA will continue to change. So let's add in Chemistry 1A taken at UCR. And we'll say that that grade was an A minus. At UCR, that is a 4-unit course. It's also taken on the quarter system. So we'll check this final column box. And it is a course taught out of the chemistry department. So it does fall under the math and science. Now at UCR, we teach a separate lab for chemistry. So we'll also need to enter in Chem 1LA. And for example, we'll say that this student maybe had a slightly lower grade in the lab of a B minus. The units in the lab are 1, it's still a math and science GPA, and it was taken on the quarter system, so we check this final box. As we've done that, now we have a running BCPM or science GPA that's also being calculated. You can follow this same model to continue to enter in all of your science classes as well as all of your non-science courses, whether they were taken on the quarter system or the semester system, for your freshman year, your sophomore year, your junior year, and your senior year. And down at the bottom, you have a complete undergraduate cumulative GPA and a complete undergraduate science GPA. This undergraduate cumulative science GPA is the most important factor for students to be thinking about when it comes to their GPA. We're less concerned about your cumulative GPA and more concerned about your science GPA. This calculation is something, again, that all students are going to need to do, as the science GPA that's calculated in your student record is not going to be synonymous with the science GPA that's calculated by all individual professional programs. So before you meet with an HPAC advisor, if you have concerns about your GPA being competitive for your professional program, please follow this tutorial. You can find this AMCAS Excel document on the HPAC homepage, as well as through a Google search by searching AMCAS Excel doc. You can then follow this tutorial to have your math and science GPA effectively calculated prior to your HPAC advising appointment. I hope this was helpful.